Hello guys, thanks for tuning in to this amazing video. So I want us to look at this game that was played on the 1st of September in the chess.com title Tuesday. The time control was 3 minutes plus 1 second increment. So let's go through this amazing game. I'm sure you guys would like it. Okay, so I was playing black in this game versus a well-known grandmaster, Pavel Eljanov from Ukraine. So yeah, so let's dive into the game, guys. So I was playing black here. You started with e4, I went e6, of course known as the French defense. He went d3 for the King's Indian attack setup, and then d5, usual stuff. Knight d2, knight c6. Okay, so here I wouldn't be surprised if somebody says this is a weird looking move, because of course the knight looks a bit weird, but this is actually it's playable. This is normal stuff. So knight f3, I played knight f6, normal developing my knight, and then g3, I took on e4, pawn takes on e4, bishop c5, developing my bishop, obviously also preparing to castle, and the bishop is looking at f2 pawn as well. So he played bishop g2, preparing to castle as well, and then I go e5. Now my terrible bishop is now no more a terrible bishop, because I played e5 and the bishop can fully move to g4 or e6. So white castles, I castle here, plays queen e2. Okay, so I go a5. So a5, usually white wants to go c3 here and then go b4. I take my bishop in some lines, so a5 is already stopping that. But not only that, I'm also preparing to go b6 and then bishop a6, since the rook is already supporting the a6 square. So he played a4, then I played b6, giving my bishop options to go either to the side, queen or the king side. Okay, and then c3 here, bishop a6, knight c4, I play queen e7. So I want to get my queen out of the file, because this rook can easily go there, and I want my rook to get hold of the file, and I can play queen e6 anytime. So plays knight h4, obviously threatening knight f5, hitting the queen, also having some nice opportunities here around my king. So I go queen e6 immediately, just to avoid all of that. And then not only that, I'm putting more pressure on the knight on c4. So b3 is kind of forced here. So I play b3, I play h6, because I do not want to see this bishop on g5. It's a bit annoying when it starts coming around my king. So plays knight f5, okay, and then I play rook e8. Okay, so here, of course, there might be a debate about which is the better rook to move to the center, but at this point, it doesn't really matter. So I just want to get hold of the open file. So bishop h3, obviously, as you can see, threatening knight h6, discovered attack towards my queen, and this would be checked, by the way, so it's very, very dangerous. So I decided, okay, I'll just move my queen to e8. And avoid all of that drama. So rook e1, and then okay, so looking at my pieces here, my pieces look not so bad. I mean, it's only this rook, okay, maybe in the queen as well, they are kind of misplaced, but if you look at this knight, it's not really doing much here. As you can see, the pawn here is very strong, covering the squares for my knight. So I thought, okay, since this knight on f5 is a bit problematic around my king, why not exchange my knight, which is a bit lazy there, for his knight, which is a bit powerful here. So of course you cannot take here, guys, because the knight is pinned. Bishop still eyeing here on a6. So knight e7, queen f3, getting off the pin. Okay, so I take the knight first, bishop takes, and then I take his knight, simply because okay, the queen has moved, so I have to take, so that I give him this uncomfortable pawn structure. And okay, so far I think I was better here. I think I was better here looking at the pawn structure. So I played queen c6, obviously guiding my knight here. Of course, there are some opportunities of bishop takes h6, g takes with the queen taking it, but of course without the bishop on f5. So queen c6, plays h4. Okay, okay, so it's obviously it's going for the queen side attack, I mean king side attack, trying to open up lines towards my king. And yeah, my king is not that safe, it's only the knight defending around my king. So I played bishop e7 just to defend the knight, also looking at the c4 pawn with my queen. So queen e2, defending the pawn. Then I played rook e8. Why? Because I just said the knight only was the only piece around here defending my king. So maybe now I have the chance to get bishop f8 and kind of defend my pawns around the king. So king h2, obviously preparing rook g1, g4, g5. Okay, so I need to play active as well. I need to play active. As you can see, I'm still up on the clock as almost always. Okay, so knight d7, maneuvering the knight and then going to the other side. Because here, if he goes g4, g5, he has the tempo because my knight is on f6. So g5 will come with tempo because they're taking my knight. So I'd rather just avoid all of that. And now g4 is not possible because bishop can take on h4. So knight d7 is quite a nice maneuver. Okay, so here he played rook d1. I played knight c5. Obviously going for an outpost. So an outpost is a square that cannot be attacked by any pawn. So if there was a pawn on d2 or b2 or b3 or d3, c5 wouldn't be an outpost because there were pawns that could attack the square. So if there's a pawn, so if there isn't a pawn that can attack the square, it is an outpost. So for example, b3 is also an outpost here because there's no pawn that can attack it. Okay, so knight c5, rook d5. Okay, so this move, this was a very nice move. So this rook looks very good here, and if I take it, I'm just helping him here with this structure because c takes d5 would be his next move. So I thought, okay, since that rook just jumped to d5, I need to keep that rook away from that. And there's only one way to keep that rook away from that square is by going c6. So with that, I moved queen f6, defending my pawn at the same time, threatening to go c6 and kicking the rook away. So I played bishop a3 here. I played c6. Okay, so I'm thinking with the idea of playing bishop a3, he wants to take here, and if I take, and then do you see that we have opposite colored bishops, and then he has drawing chances, and his weak pawns are on his light squares, and I have a dark squared bishop, so it's a bit safe there. But after c6, he played the move rook d1. Okay, I was surprised here. Why was he playing such a move? Okay, as you can see, guys, there was a whole minute up here on the clock. So I played rook d1. I thought he was going for the opposite colored bishops. So, okay, maybe taking here is not the best right now because bishop takes here and then rook takes the pawn. So I started with g6, kicking the bishop away from that square, also opening a window for my king. So bishop h3, and then I took the rook. This rook had to take because if queen takes, and then this pawn on f2 will be hanging. So rook takes, and then I comfortably took on a4 with my knight. So bishop takes bishop, queen takes bishop. Obviously, you don't want to take with the rook here and give him some chances like checking here, king here, and the rook starts swinging over to the other side. So just queen takes, and then queen e3. Obviously, they're taking the pawn on h6, and then I have to go king g7, rook d7, queen f6, just keeping an eye on that pawn on f2. So rook b7, I don't know why he was attacking this pawn because it's defended, but as you can see here, black is much better. I think if not, black is winning actually here. So there wasn't really enough he could go for here. So rook d8, obviously open file, looking at some rook d3 ideas with knight c5, because, and also rook d2, putting more pressure on that f2 pawn. So he plays king g2. I play h5 just for control, and as you can see, guys, I was up on time and he had 28 seconds. So h5 is not surprising at all. I mean, you can make that move just to see his clock go down. So okay, so he played queen e2 here. I played queen d6. Why? Because I wanted to play queen d2 or queen d3 or queen d1, so to exchange queens. Okay, then he played queen f3 here, and then I realized, okay, no, I cannot really do any of this because there's this threat here. So I played back queen f6, since my idea was to exchange queens anyway, so I played queen f6, but he did not want to exchange queens, so I played queen e2 back. Then I realized, okay, we're not going to be repeating moves, and then I played a prophylactic move, rook d6, just to see what else he can do on the board. And then, fortunately, he made this blunder here. Okay, but this position is already winning for black, so c5, I simply took here. So as you can see, I took 7 seconds to think about that, and then I took played queen e3. As you can see, the pawn is defended here. So I played c5. Why? Because remember, when I moved this rook to d8, guys, I wanted the idea to put the rook on d3 and put more pressure on the king and the pawn on c3. So I played rook b8. Okay, so I played rook d3, finally get the move I was looking for. And now queen a7, queen leaves the king, and of course there's nothing much you can do in this position. So even a move like queen e2, I was going to play knight takes c3, and it's just lost for white. So queen a7, queen f3 check, obviously king h2. Okay, so it's important not to make this mistake because the queen is still eyeing there. So there's only one way to stop the queen. So we block the queen, play c5. Okay, I mean rook d2 maybe is another move, but c5 I think is the best move here. C5, just cutting the queen out from defending the f2 pawn. So plays queen e7. Okay, so this was his last chance to try anything for like queen f8, queen h8 checks. So now I took on f2, and then yeah, so in this position he resigned, but this was already over because after bishop g2. Okay, so bishop g2, queen just takes on g3, and then king h1, and then rook d3, and it's a simple checkmate. So that was a very nice and very nice and interesting game that I played versus Grandmaster Eljanov Pavel from Ukraine. So just to go through the moves again, quickly go through the moves, you guys can watch the game again. Alright, so yeah, that's about it. So thank you guys for tuning in, and I hope you enjoyed the video. So please hit that like button and subscribe, guys, and I would appreciate that. And yeah, looking forward to more videos, guys. Stay tuned.